Hi everyone, Phil Pendlebury here, and hope you're having a super mega large day. Well, today we're going to have a look at a game changer. It's the new Clarity plugin from Waves. All right, so I've got a new Endo 11 open, and I've also loaded up the new Clarity VX Pro from Waves. And this, like I said earlier, is a game changer. The idea of Clarity VX is to help you remove voices or vocals from music and background noise, or vice versa, to help you remove background noise or music from tracks and leave the voice outstanding. It does this using new kind of neural network technology, they call it. They've analyzed millions of samples and they've really come up with a winning solution here as far as I'm concerned. There's quite a lot of advanced features here, but what we're going to do today is just quickly go through the basics. There's two versions of the plugin as well. If I can just bring the other one up. There's the main Clarity VX Pro, which has quite a lot of extra features and functions. And then there's the basic version, which is just Clarity VX. So we'll do the Pro version first, have a quick look at that, and then we'll take it from there. Incidentally, the neural network, you can adjust the different ways that this works. Again, I'm not going to go into that in too much detail right now. There is a manual that comes with it. There's also some advanced controls, which I'll just quickly skip through. Reflections controls the release times of the network process. So it's how quickly it sort of stops working, basically. The neural network selector, which we just mentioned, gives you an options. Broad one is to isolate primary and secondary voices from ambience. This one here, the HF, separates primary and secondary voices from ambience, similar to broad one, but with a high frequency focus. And finally, the let's drop that down to broad two. This is to isolate the primary voice from secondary voices and ambience. The choice focus is on the main speaker, singer, separating it from ambience. I think the easiest thing to do with this is to just listen to it and you'll see what all these things do. The ambience gate controls are quite useful. And what that helps you to do is sets the amount of ambience attenuation within non-voiced areas. So if you increase the setting, you'll get rid of more of the ambience. So that's if you're looking at getting rid of voices. So let's just get on with it, have a little mess around. I'm going to leave it on broad one to start off with. So here we are, and here's a project that I've finished work on earlier on. Some of you might have seen this. It's my little voiceover showreel. So I'll play you a little bit of it just so you can get the idea.
Hello, can I help you?
Hello. Do you mind if I have a look around your studio?
No problem. Come on in and I'll show you some of the things going on here. We're recording lots of voices today. Let's have a look and see what's going on in Studio One.
Okay.
Looks like someone's reading the news. A statement has been released today by Sahib Anthony Didibinini Bibisa, Prime Minister of Smegville. Mr. Didibinini Bibisa has warned all his loyal subjects.
Starring Tom Bruise as Jack Lemmon, the man who drives a smart car but thinks he's driving a bus.
Okay, so you get the idea. It's a voice showreel. There's bits of music, there's sound effects, there's background noise, there's all sorts of things going on. So we'll use this as an example. I'm going to enable the plugin now. And what I'm going to do is I've inserted this on the master output. So it's literally on the master output of the entire mix of the showreel. And you'll see what happens. I've got the big knob here in front of me. Let's get rid of advanced controls for now. Let's just concentrate on this. You'll see what happens as I adjust this, and it's absolutely stunning.
Hello, can I help you?
Hello. Do you mind if I have a look around your studio?
No problem. Come on in and I'll show you some of the things going on here. We're recording lots of voices today. Let's have a look and see what's going on in Studio One.
Okay.
Ah, looks like someone's reading the news. And now, the news. A statement has been released today by Sahib Anthony Didibinini Bibisa, Prime Minister of Smegville. Mr. Didibinini Bibisa has warned all his loyal subjects that they should never, under any circumstances, type Google into Google, as this may...
As you can see, very convincingly got rid of everything that was going on there, apart from the voice. And that was without any tweaking at all. Now, I know we have other tools to do this, but this actually, to me, almost seems to be doing it better than anything else I've heard or used so far. And don't forget, like I said, we've done that without any tweaking. Let's have a further experiment. I want to play you some of the more complex voices and see how it deals with that.
Thinking of purchasing a new mobile telephone? It's two for the price of three all week at Care 5. Sale starts on Sunday morning. Come on down on Sunday night. Sleep over in our specially designed tents to avoid the rush. Grab the Apple. Thinking of purchasing a new mobile telephone? It's two...
Yeah, doesn't work super well with that one. Let's have a listen to the Scotsman.
What do you think you're doing? I'm trying to record a scientific show in here. It's taken me all week to get the whiskey bottles lined up correctly, and now you've gone and spoiled it all. What do you think you're doing? I'm trying to record a science. What do you think you're doing? I'm trying to record a scientific show in here. It's taken me all week to get the whiskey bottles lined up correctly, and now you've gone and spoiled it all. What do you think you're doing? I'm trying to record a scientific show in here. It's taken me all week to get the whiskey bottles lined up correctly, and now you've gone and spoiled it all. What do you think you're doing? I'm trying to record a scientific show in here. It's taken me all week to get the whiskey bottles lined up correctly, and now you've gone and spoiled it all. What do you think you're doing? I'm trying to record a scientific show in here. It's taken me all week to get the whiskey bottles lined up correctly, and now you've gone and spoiled it all. What do you think you're doing? I'm trying to record a scientific show in here. It's taken me all week to get the whiskey bottles lined up correctly, and now you've gone and spoiled it all. What do you think you're doing? I'm trying to record a scientific show in here. It's taken me all week to get the whiskey bottles lined up correctly, and now you've gone and spoiled it all.
That's pretty impressive, because that is a very difficult voice to deal with. Obviously, it's talking like that, but not only that, there's a lot of other processing that's involved. Let's find just some normal voice, which would be just me speaking. Let's have a listen to that.
Okay, I think we should leave that there. I had no idea they were in here. In fact, if you don't mind, I'm just going to have a quick word with Tracy. Just give me 1 minute. Hello, Tracy? Please can you take a note not to allow any bludgeoning or killing of gardeners in future, especially using death rays, laser beams or lightsabers. Thanks. Right, well, okay, I think we should leave that there. I had no idea they were in here. In fact, if you don't mind, I'm just going to have a quick word with Tracy. Just give me 1 minute.
So you can get the idea there. Basically, we've got a lot of ways of controlling what's removed and what stays in. And it works with music too, of course, but we'll leave that for another video. Let's just find another voice and see how it deals with something a little bit more complicated. I'll set this back to zero.
Well, your reverence, that's really wonderful to hear. Really, really wonderful. I feel absolutely rhapsodic about the fact that you're sparing me. Thank you so much, your reverence. Well, your reverence, that's really wonderful to hear. Really, really wonderful. I feel absolutely rhapsodic about the fact that you're sparing me. Thank you so much, your reverence. Will, your reverence. That's really wonderful to hear. Really, really wonderful. I feel absolutely rhapsodic about the fact that you're sparing me. Thank you so much, your reverence. Will, your reverence. That's really wonderful to hear. Really, really wonderful. I feel absolutely rhapsodic about the fact that you're sparing me. Thank you so much, your reverence.
Right, so that's, yeah, dealt with that one okay. Much better with the regular voices, I think. But I don't know whether I should try it on my Dark Lloyd voice. I suppose it's worth a quick go. Let's have a quick listen to this one without any effects, because there's lots of effects underneath. So we'll
all except the gardener. He is very important to me, and I like his beard. All except the gardener. He is very important to me, and I like his beard. All except the gardener. He is very important to me, and I like his beard. All except the gardener. He is very important to me, and I like his beard. All except the gardener. He is very important to me, and I like his beard. All except the gardener. He is very important to me.
Let's now have a quick look at the plain VX version. So there's not so much advanced controls on this. So all you've got really here is the ability to reduce ambience. And width can be done as well, which we're not really going to use today. And again, you've got the double or single analysis. Let's just give it a go. Once again, I will play you this on, I'll play you one of my just regular voice.
Hello, can I help you?
Hello, do you mind if I have a look around your studio?
Well, obviously that's not all my regular voice, but you know what I mean.
No problem. Come on in and I'll show you some of the things going on here. We're recording lots of voices today. Let's have a look and see what's going on in Studio One.
Okay.
Ah, looks like someone reading the news. Hello, can I help you?
Hello, do you mind if I have a look around your studio?
No problem. Come on in and I'll show you some of the things going on here. We're recording lots of voices today. Let's have a look and see what's going on in Studio One.
Okay.
Ah, looks like someone's reading the news. Hello, can I help you?
Hello, do you mind if the studio?
No problem. Come on in and I'll show you some of the things going on here. We're recording lots of voices today. Let's have a look and see what's going on in Studio One.
Okay.
Ah, looks like someone's reading the news. Hello, can I help you?
Hello, do you mind if I have...
Okay, so we're back to the main Clarity VX again, and just quickly again point out a couple of things. Obviously the single and double, I forgot to point this out earlier on, but this, if you put it into double mode, it'll actually analyze the left and right channel separately, which is why it doubles the processing power. So it doesn't actually do a double process, as it were. It just analyzes both channels separately in case you've got voices that are panned around. And in fact, in this case, I actually have, but unfortunately, like I said, it's very heavy on the processor here. There's other controls, the processor mount and the ambience gate, which I think we demonstrated earlier on. But let's just have another quick listen to how it deals with a plain voice.
Hello, can I help you?
Hello, do you mind if I have a look around your studio?
No problem. Come on in and I'll show you some of the things going on here. We're recording lots of voices today. Let's have a look and see what's going on in Studio One.
Okay.
Pretty impressive, I think. I did give it a bit of a challenge with my weird voices and, the gravelly sounds and the way that things are panned and EQ'd and so on. But I think this is a game changer. Have a look yourself and see what you think. That's all for now on this one. Have a good day. Cheers.